India today successfully launched a long-range missile that's able to hit parts of China and Europe with a nuclear warhead. It's named after the Hindu god of fire. It's a 50-ton, three-stage rocket that puts India in a small club of nations with the power to develop and build long-range ballistic missiles. But in contrast with North Korea's recent failed missile test, there is hardly any international blowback over India's new weapon. The chief Fox Sports correspondent, Jonathan Hunt, has the news. And Jonathan, Indian military officials seem, I don't know, pretty fired up about this development.
Yeah, they see it as a huge technical achievement and a big step on the path toward becoming a major world power. They're also quick to point out that this is not supposed to demonstrate any offensive power, but merely to act as a deterrent. And what it's about here is the range of this missile. They've had nukes for quite some time, but now they can aim those nuclear warheads, or will be able to in a couple of years, east towards China and west toward Iran. And that is the key for the Indians here.
But most interesting in all of this is nobody seems to care.
Yeah, very interesting. The U.S. officials say that this is very different because India is a stable democracy, as opposed to North Korea, who attempted that failed launch last week, which they say is an unpredictable dictatorship. Now, although the State Department spokesman, Mark Toner, did seem to struggle a little today when asked to explain how this fit into the administration's general call for restraint among nuclear nations in their testing programs. Listen.
We believe, they have a solid non-proliferation record, and that they're, they're playing a significant role internationally on the issue.
The bottom line, U.S. officials feel that India is a friend, and having one more friend with the ability to hit Iran is probably no bad thing, although they'd never say that in public.
No, but that's well put. Jonathan Hunt, thanks so much.
And now for some Chinese perspective about the Indians' missile launch, we're joined on the phone by Mr. Li Bin from Tsinghua University. Well, Mr. Li, compared to previous missile tests by India, what is special about this one?
This new missile, Agni 5, would have a much longer range than previous one. The previous one at a range of 3,500 kilometers. Mm. This one may have a range of 5,000 kilometers. That is the difference. The range is much larger.
So you're talking about the range of this missile. That means the missile can easily reach any parts of China. So do you think the target, potential target, is China?
I'm not that sure. I believe that this is a part of the Indian's ambition to raise the status of India in the world. The Indian people always feel that India is a great country and always want to have equal position with other big powers. So they have made a lot of efforts for this purpose. I think this is one of these efforts.
And earlier, our reporter in India said that the missile defense capability build-up is for defense purposes rather than offense purposes. Do you agree?
I'm not that sure, but India is another country who has a no-first use policy. That is the policy of China has the same policy, that is not to use nuclear weapon first. India has the same kind of policy. So from that point of view, we could say that India may have some kind of constraint over its nuclear capability. Still, we are not so sure how India's political decision would change after its military capability grows.
All right, there are still some questions remain unanswered. Thank you, Mr. Li, for your perspective. That's Mr. Li Bin from Tsinghua University.
成功进行了猎火5导弹的第三次试射。猎火5呢，是印度射程最远的导弹，由印度媒体将其称为所谓的中国杀手。不过，中印关系依然稳步推进。印度外长斯瓦拉杰周六抵达了北京，并出席第二届中印媒体高峰论坛。 烈火五星弹道导弹在位于印度东部孟加拉湾海域的惠勒岛进行了试射。与前两次采用水泥发射台发射不同，本次试射首次采用了在卡车上架设导弹筒的方式进行发射。印度时报解释说，与之前基本上在铁路上机动的导弹不同，烈火五可以很容易地存储在密封箱内，并且在公路上靠发射车快速运输，这将使得军队具有操作上的灵活性，选择从哪里发射导弹。报道还指，烈火五拥有精确度极高的惯性导航系统。试射成功后，印度总理莫迪立即在推特上发文称，烈火五成功从导弹筒试射之后成为印度军方的珍贵资产。烈火五导弹是一种三级固体燃料导弹，是印度射程最远的导弹。印度时报的文章称，烈火五可以覆盖中国全境与部分欧洲地区，再加上 1.2 吨左右的运载能力，配合初级的核弹头制造能力，印度的核威慑能力正在逐步成为现实。有分析认为，射程较短的烈火一、二型导弹的研发主要是考量传统敌手巴基斯坦，而印度后来研发射程较长的烈火导弹则是针对中国。印度斯坦时报的报道强调，烈火五型导弹及其原型烈火三型导弹是为了威慑中国而量身定做的。美国国家利益网站也以目的地北京、印度试射中国杀手核导弹的耸动标题进行炒作。
主要是印度媒体是在炒作。那么对于美国来说，它一方面呢看到印度的这种远程导弹会对中国构成比较大的一个威慑，另一方面对印度不断的提升弹道导弹射程，它也感到一些担心。这么远的射程的话，肯定就不只是对中国。
烈火五被当地媒体称为印度第一枚洲际弹的导弹，但是严格说，它只是一种中程弹的导弹。专家指出，从技术角度看，烈火五导弹还非常原始。首先，火箭发动机比较落后，导弹总重50吨，射程仅有5000公里。美国现役的民兵三型洲际导弹总重35吨，射程1.3万公里。俄罗斯现役主力白羊 M 洲际弹道导弹总重47吨，射程10000公里。而中国的东风31A 导弹总重42吨，射程1.2万公里。其次，从发动机工作时间来看，印度烈火五一级发动机工作时间90秒，二级和三级的工作时间各为75秒。而美俄中法的导弹各级发动机工作时间均在60秒左右，烈火五在助推上升阶段的消耗时间超出平均水平的33%，长达1分钟。在以秒计算的反导预警中，多给对手1分钟的探测预警时间，就意味着更大的被拦截几率。第三，从制导系统来看，印度目前不能自行生产高精度的惯性导航组件。印度目前使用的惯导元件上